When Sir Maya Gertie's parents held the newborn child for the first time, they hardly could have imagined that 11 short years later, she would die a martyr and a saint. Yet while her faith was unknown to them, her parents did much to help her prepare for that fateful day. From her parents, Sir Maya Gertie was taught piety and devotion. She was cheerful and she was also known to be generous, sharing her meager food with her siblings. Saint Maya Gertie was also deeply devoted to Our Lady and wore a rosary around her wrist so she could pray often. Her mother and father were poor in goods of the earth, but they were rich in faith, a faith which they generously shared with their children.
Kingdom of Rome. Me and my family, hoping to rise from our desperate poverty, moved to the Pontine marshes. My parents, infested, worked as tenant farmers in disease-infested swamp, and soon a swamp-borne disease claimed the life of my father, Luigi. My mother, Asunta, was then left to provide entirely for my family. At age 11, I received first communion with great devotion. Just a month afterwards, I was called to receive a double crown of martyrdom and purity. On July 5th, 1902, the 20-year-old son of the Senelese, Alessandro, pulled a knife on me, intending to force me to commit a sin against the virtue of purity. Then I cried out, "No, no, no, it's a sin, you'll go to hell." Angrily, Alessandro stabbed me 14 times and left me for dead. Since everyone was out in the fields, no one heard my cries for help. I was finally discovered and rushed to the hospital, but little could be done. Despite my sufferings, I never opened my mouth to complain. After caring for my wounds, the doctor told the incoming priest, "Father, you have little to do. You are leaving a dying girl, but you are finding an angel." Before I died, I was asked to forgive my murderer, and I regret only as a saint could. Yes, I do for the love of Jesus. Forgive him, and I want him to be with me in paradise. May God forgive him, because I have already forgiven him.
Alessandro finally repented, and Saint Maya Gertie's dying prayer had been heard. Maya's feast, celebrated on July 6th, she is the patron saint of chastity, rape victims, girls, youth, teenage girls, poverty, purity, and forgiveness. She has rightly been described as a model for young people, but her courage and uncompromising virtue make her a model for everyone. Maya Gertie was canonized on June 24, 1950 by Pope Pius XII in St. Peter's Square. She was then the youngest person ever canonized. She also is a patron for anyone who speaks or acts against prevailing values. Most of us won't be put to that severe a test, but we face everyday situations. Saint Maya Gertie is a patron and a guide for every one of us who has ever wondered, do I have the strength to do this?